Students, namaste. Myself Seema, faculty at FPD. So today we are going to discuss about the PD management of the fracture. Okay. So basically, first we have to know what is a fracture. It's a break in the structural continuity of bone. Okay. Whichever bone we are taking, it has some structural continuity, and if there is any kind of break in that structural continuity, we can say that it's a fracture. Okay. We must know, like, since we are reading the we are here discussing the PD management and the treatment of the fracture, so what will be the goal of the treatment or the management of a fracture? So first, prevent fracture and soft tissue complications. Second, get fracture to heal and in satisfactory position for optimal functional recovery. Then again, intra-articular fractures needs accurate reduction and rigid fixation, but no articular fracture of bone requires anatomical reduction and stable. Non-articular fracture of the bone requires anatomical reduction and stable fixation. Again, rehabilitate as early as possible by active and passive exercise, and restore patient to optimal function state. Okay, so these will be the basic goals. So the first three goals, and first goal is of general of the education and things, counseling. Then second two goals, we can say it comes under the medical management, the medical team, the orthopedicians, and after the reduction, then keeping that position and keeping that fracture in its place. That's what physiotherapist can do. Then the last two will mostly be of under the physiotherapy, like rehabilitation by active or passive exercises, and restore the patient to the optimal functional state. So in a multidisciplinary system, the medical team, the physiotherapist, occupational therapist, all will come together, and these are the goals which have to achieve in the fracture management. Okay, so how fracture happens, like if we will see in a whole body, we have a bone. So how the fracture happens? A single traumatic incident, repetitive stress, abnormal weakening of the bone. Okay, so these can be the basic cause of the happening for the cause of the fracture. Now if you will see forces, the twisting cause, a spiral fracture, compression cause, short oblique fracture, bending results in fracture with a triangular butterfly fragment, tension needs to break the bone transversely. Okay, so these are the pattern, the forces that cause a specific pattern in the bone at the time of the fracture. So if you will see in anatomical overview, the types of bone fracture, here you can see normal bone, then transverse, oblique, spiral, comminuted fracture, segmental fracture, avulsed fracture, impacted fracture, torus fracture, and green stick fracture. Okay. Now, there is other classification of fracture on the basis of the injury, like what type of injury has happened. So open fracture, when the bony fragments are exposed to the external environment, that means the fracture is open fracture. And if the fragment, the fracture has not been exposed, then it's closed fracture. Now types of injury, we can see high in energy. If the impact is great, too much, the force is too much, the injury will be the bone will be separated, dislocated, the segments will be separated from each other. So here you can see in the x-ray that the segments have been dislocated. Low energy fracture, low impact fracture. So there will be you can see that the fracture is there, but it hasn't been dislocated. You can see just the line of the fracture. Now, if we will see the open fractures, then again, there are some classification, low energy. Then wound is less than 1 centimeter. If wound is more than 1 centimeter, that's the second type of that. High energy wound is more than with extensive soft tissue injury. So that is Gastillo's classification. For your knowledge purpose of view, I have put it there. Now the general complication. What are the complications that occurs? I know you all must have known that the shock, ARDS, fat embolism, Kerr syndrome, tetanus, gangrene, DVT. DVT is one of the most common and one of the general complication, we must look for and avoid, okay? Then bed sores, depressions. So these can be then the complication, the early complication and the late complication. So early complication at the time of the fracture or during the injury, during the rehabilitation, during the reduction of the fracture, or it's a clinical or medical management, what early complications can occur? Visceral, vascular, compartment syndrome, nerve injury, hematosis or infection. Then the late complication at the time of rehabilitation, after the management, early management, what are the complications that can occur? Delayed union, non-union, malunion, tendon rupture, myositis, ossificans. This condition mostly occurs of the fracture of the elbow, around the elbow joint. If there is a fracture, there is much more chances of this condition to occur. Then osteonecrosis, elbow dystrophy, osteoarthritis, joint stiffness. So these are the complications that can occur. So now management of the injured patient. If the patient has come and we have to manage, what will be management protocol or guideline? Don't treat the x-ray of the fracture, but treat the patient. Okay. So what these lines means, the patient came, we have just gone for the x-ray and see, okay, so there is a soft or humerus has been fractured, so we are just going to treat for that. No, we have to see the patient. What are the symptoms? What are the difficulty? Apart from, we know there is a fracture, but what things he is facing, and what are the clinical sign and symptoms we are finding? We have to treat that, not just the fracture. Okay. Because fracture can accompany many things, because cause of the fractures are different. If it is a road traffic accident, there can be vascular injury, shock, concussion. So there could be many things. So that's why the line is like that. Don't treat the x-ray of the fracture, but treat the patient. We must go for the sign and symptoms, the type of injury, the history and things. So we have to treat the patient. Life-saving measures, what are the life-saving? Diagnose and treat life-threatening injuries like head injury, chest, abdominal injury, emergency or orthopedics involvement, life-saving and complication saving. It's like in the spinal fracture or hip fracture. There could be a chance of emergency orthopedics management, we have seen that life-saving and complication saving. From at the time of the injury, from day one, then monitoring of the fracture days to weeks, and then rehabilitation and treatment of the complication weeks to months. So this is how the management of the injured patient, the fracture patient, goes on. The principle is like that. So what things we have to see on day one, emergency treatment, A, B, C, D, E. What are these A, B, C, D, E? Airways and cervical, spine immobilization. This ABCDE procedure, if possible, should be done at the fracture site only, wherever the fracture has occurred, or immediately as soon as the patient has entered the hospital or the medical center. Then breathing should be checked, that whether the patient is breathing properly or not, the inspiration and expiration is going on, there is chest movement, proper chest movement. Then C, circulation should be checked for, that there should not be any bleeding, there should not be any internal bleeding. How you can see the internal bleeding? By exposing the body, there should not be any hematoma or something like that, or immediate swelling other than the fracture site. So these things we must see for. And the urine and fecal output also. Then the D, disability. Okay, how the disability we will see? The head injury, that paralysis or something like that. Then E, exposure, musculoskeletal injury. Where the patient is not, which part of the body is non-responding, where there is immediate swelling and pain, how the patient is complaining about the pain or about any part of the body, or whether the injury is open or closed. So ABCD principles should be followed. If we will see the proper treatment procedure, that treatment principle of fracture, reduction will be there. Then maintain reduction. Then rehabilitate and prevent and treat complication. Okay, so this is the basic treatment principle. Now, if we will go through the hereby we have seen reduction and maintenance of reduction. These two things will come under the medical management team. Okay, so reduction, orthopedician will reduce either by the conservative method, by just reduction, or by open reduction, internal fixation, or any procedure, whatever is the requirement for the present injury. Then maintenance of that reduction by the plaster, by the nails, by the plates, by some other techniques, by the bands, by the slings. So whatever is the required protocol there at the type of the fracture, the maintenance is needed. In the maintenance, physiotherapists will also help by proper positioning of that part, positioning of the body. So in the maintenance portion, physiotherapist can also guide the patient. Now the rehabilitation part. Rehabilitation part, physiotherapist plays the important place, one of the very important role. So rehabilitation, what rehabilitation includes? Restore of function by movement of all joints and patient itself, and prevent or treat complication. So this part we have to focus here, that PD management of fractures. So if we will combinedly see all the fractures, like what would be the PT management. So during the period of the immobilization, that will be decided on the basis of the type of fracture or by the physician or by the orthopedician. So during the period of the immobilization, the physiotherapist will not put any effort on that portion, the part which has been fractured or reduced, but the proximal and distal part from that portion, from that injury site, should be looked for, should be mobilized for. The muscles and their property, the movement, the strength, the endurance should be maintained by the physiotherapist. And after the period of immobilization, then again, that part has been in the period of immobilization, the strength, the mobility will be lost, the contractures can be there, stiffness can be there, the arthrokinematics movement will be lost or restricted. So the physiotherapist will use mobilization technique, stretching technique, strengthening technique, from isometrics to closed chain to open chain technique. All these techniques will physiotherapist use, and ultimately help in gaining the restoring the function of that joint or whole of the joint, the body and the patient itself, and then treat the patient. Okay, so this is how the PT management of the fractures in general goes on. Either we can take the PT management of the fracture of humerus or femur or anything. So post immobilization and during the phase of the immobilization, there are two parts of rehabilitation. So in both the rehabilitation protocol, some will be in protective phase, some will be in during the period of immobilization, the pressure you are putting to the distal joint or to the injured site will be of limited, so that it cannot be transferred on that, or it cannot misalign the fracture site again. So these are the precautions a physiotherapist must take. So exercises will include strengthening exercise, mobility exercise, active and passive mobilization, ROM exercises, stretching exercises. Then in strengthening exercises, we can go from isometrics to open chain, to closed chain, to open chain, then weight bearing, weight lifting. So whole of the procedure of the physiotherapy rehabilitation will be like that, depending upon the type of the fracture. Okay, so this is how we manage the fracture. Then the complication, non-weight bearing exercises will be continued, if we will take the fracture of the tibia. So tibial fracture do need weight bearing exercises, weight bearing rehabilitation at some time period. And if the physiotherapist is not doing it, then the bone growth and the bone development will not be of that good. So there could be chance of the malunion or non-union. So according to that, the future complications can be avoided by the proper exercises and following the proper treatment protocol. Okay, other than that, like DVT kind of complication, so ankle toe pump exercises, stretching of the calf muscles and mobility if the patient is able to mobile by partial weight bearing or non-weight bearing to that injured limb, then mobility should be encouraged. So that there won't be any chances of thrombosis or DVT or any embolus. Okay, so this is how a physiotherapist can prevent or treat many complications. So hereby we are completing the PT management of fractures in general. And in our problem solving class, you can ask any questions or PT management, any doubts on the PT management of any particular type of fracture. So we will discuss it there. In general, whole of the body PT management for fractures we have discussed. Do read about this topic, and as you have already read all type of fractures in the body, if you have any doubts in any type of fracture or their rehabilitation, you can ask me directly in our Google solving class. So thank you. Hereby I am ending this lecture.